What you see here would once upon a time have been considered a rare sight. This is a Cape Mountain zebra, a species once pushed to the brink by hunting and expansion of agricultural activities in its natural range. Today, however, this species has recovered, and over 5,000 individuals occur in reserves scattered around the western and eastern Cape provinces of South Africa. At the center of this conservation success story is a small, unassuming national park nestled in the rolling hills of the Great Karoo. In 1937, the Mountain Zebra National Park was proclaimed, with the primary goal being to bring this unique equid species back from the edge of extinction. In late September 2023, a bunch of fellow vet students and I set off to explore this unique little park.
Yo, so now listen, we've actually landed ourselves in a very familiar situation, one that we're very used to. We've got 5 minutes, you can call it four, to probably do around 8 minutes worth of driving. So we're just going at the speed limit. Of course, that is difficult on these very windy, high altitude roads.
Oh my, which you are doing with one hand.
don't panic. And you know what, we're not gonna speed, but we're also gonna be brisk about it. And hope that perhaps something jumps in the road and we see it. So yeah, wish us luck.
Needless to say, not much else was seen that drive. However, the following morning, we jumped onto one of the park vehicles to take part in a cheetah tracking excursion. At the time of our visit, the park's cheetah population was a humble 8. Mike and Dan, the park's 2 adult male cheetahs, CJ and her 4 young cubs, and the cheetah that you're currently looking at now, Rachel. She's a young female, recently brought in from Samara Karoo Game Reserve near Grofrenet. All of the park's adult cheetahs are fitted with VHF and GPS tracking collars. This is done to monitor them at all times. It helps to prevent things like inbreeding and also reduces human-wildlife conflict in the event that a cheetah does escape into a neighboring sheep farm. One of the other benefits of the tracking collars is that they can monitor which cheetahs are mating with who. I'm told that Rachel has been mating with Mike and is thought to be pregnant. Hopefully she conceives and does her bit for cheetah conservation.
Here we have ground squirrels, and this one in particular goes by the name Nuts, Mr. Nuts.
Goodbye, Mr. Nuts.
The reason, absolutely important, the reason is because they've got enormous testes.
Oh, the purple flowers.
The one in the distance.
Can I go forward? Idea potentially
limitable. Oh yeah, please.
You mean a schematable?
Schematable.
No.
No, the Drongo Lane.
What do you mean lane?
That's the Drongo.
Your lane. What do you mean lane?
Lane.
This was easy.
Lane.
A potential skimtar bill, right, buddy?
Fish.
No. A midden. Sorry, got you hooked up there.
Okay, well, anyway, welcome to our first early morning drive. Yesterday morning, we did our cheetah tracking, which was a bit of a wild goose chase, but in the end, we got rewarded. But this morning, we're heading up the Kranskorp Loop to go and see what there is to see. So, you must wish us luck. Please. Please. So this plant that we are looking at here is a parasitic plant of the mistletoe, and Mountain Zebra National Park has got a big issue with it because there's such a high number of frugivorous birds like barbets and mouse birds, and they come in and they eat some of the sort of the pulpy part of the plant, which also contains the seeds, and then they go and they wipe their bill against twigs of the neighboring tree, and that's how it spreads. And so when you come to Mountain Zebra, you'll see a hell of a lot of mistletoe, so don't get caught with laying underneath mistletoe. You might have a nasty surprise in store.
We have just had the most incredible sighting of a swan-tailed bee eater, which is a vagrant for this area. So gracias, your host, Edie Wildlife.
Ooh, here we go. Ooh.
Proof. Gold proof. Hard proof.
Oh, there they are. Oh, they're back.
They're back.
And they're back.
They're back.
Thank you.
As the sun began to set over the park, we decided to go on a night drive. In my experience, the Mountain Zebra National Park is one of the best national parks to do a night drive, and we certainly were not disappointed on this occasion.
What have we seen?
So far, we've seen 4 female lions here in Mountain Zebra National Park. All in contraceptives, so they're a bit big. And I'm a little jealous of the gains.
You're a little jealous of the what?
The gains.
The gains. Oh, yeah. No, the contraceptive implant that they use here lasts about 5 years. And for the whole duration, it completely messes up their hormones. And as a result, they gain weight. So we are busy watching some thick lions. No, they're huge.
Healthy mouths.
Very healthy, and then hopefully the contraceptive implant wears off fairly soon and we'll have some cubs right now. Left those lions, and it was what a fantastic sighting it was. An unsuccessful hunt, even calling it a hunt was probably a bit generous. I think it was more a stalk than anything. Eh?
Yeah, 100%.
So nice. All 4 females, there are only 4 in the park, and then 2 males. And so, yeah, it was really nice just to see them out and about in the open, walking around, stalking. So, it was a good sighting, you know, better than what you normally get with lions. But onwards we shall bumble, still lots to see, hopefully we get lucky. Wish us luck.
As our time in the park drew to a close, our final afternoon drive consisted of sightings of the usual suspects: eland, hartebeest, springbok, and the ever-present Cape Mountain Zebra. We were also very fortunate to get a quick glimpse of CJ and her cubs resting under a tree in the heat of the day. It wasn't the clearest sighting, but it was so fantastic to be in her presence. Our luck during our stay, however, had not run out, and the following morning, before we packed up camp, a quick little 1-hour loop turned into a very, very exciting drive.
Alright, so that brings our stay in Mountain Zebra National Park to a close. We went on a quick early morning drive this morning, just about 2 hours up onto the Rooiplaat Loop, and we did find one of the male lions, I think it's Nomad, and one of the females as well, who I couldn't identify. But now we're all packed up and we're ready to rock and roll, and we are all really sad.
What is it?
Oh, yeah,
it's fine.
Like,
I can just add it.
It's okay. We'll be back. Are you sad?
Oh, I'm so sad.
Cry.
No, we've had a really good time here. Saw some really cool things, cool birds. So it's looking good, yeah.
Absolutely. So we'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.
Hi, my name is Lane. I have a birding problem.